Hello, everybody, and welcome to the last episode of today's Grimco virtual trade show experience. We're showcasing all of our exclusives today, and if you have been following along with all the sessions today, now's the time to maybe go make a cocktail, get comfortable, because this part, the first part might be a little bit redundant for you, but I do want to welcome you guys all. We are in the Grimco Chicago brand new distribution hub. That is a beautiful 100,000 square feet of beautiful shelves and the warehousing. You know, forklifts are going everywhere. And but the best part about this place is this 5,000 square feet demo center. So that's where we've been broadcasting all day in different sections of the room. So as you've seen different angles, we've got everything from the HPR series. We've got Epson roll to rolls, HP latex, all the cutters, all the plotters, everything that you would ever expect to see in a state-of-the-art demo center. So here is where we do a lot of live demos, actually, whenever customers want to learn a little bit more about a piece of equipment that they're interested in. This place is run by one of the best, Neil McNarma, who I call Neil McNamarama. He is very, very experienced. He's been in the industry for a tremendous amount of time. He loves these machines. He knows them inside and out. So if you're ever interested in learning more about any piece of equipment, get in touch with us, because we can not only demo something live for you, but when you're comfortable and when you're able, come on up. We would love to see you as a guest here, and so you can get hands-on experience and see all the equipment that we have to showcase. So if you're ever in the need for upgrading as well, reach out to us. We want to use this to its full capacity. So for those of you that aren't so familiar with Grimco, Grimco was founded in 1875, which is a little bit of time now, so we've got our bearings. And we are a wholesale distributor for the sign and manufacturing science plate industry. We have everything, we offer everything, not only just our exclusive brands, we are a huge distributor for 3M, Avery, Orifil, you name it. So we have everything to service our customers, from LEDs to print media, printers like we just talked about, other fabrication equipment, traffic signs, and rigid substrates, and that's only the tip of the iceberg. So what we're committed to here at Grimco is helping our customers, such as yourself, in the sign and graphics industry to grow their business. We've got five distribution hubs in the United States with 50 locations across the country, as well as in Canada. So we have grown tremendously over the years. When I started back in 2008, we had one main distribution hub down in Owensville, Missouri. And since then, it has just exploded. We're fortunate and humbled that we have experienced growth year after year, because we're here because you're here. So today's format, what we've been following, we're doing sessions that are a 30-minute training session. Today's, you're joined in right now in the Duratex section. And those are going to be followed by a 15-minute Q&A section. So each segment has a panelist online to answer all of your questions throughout the demo. So you'll see on your Zoom screen, you've got a Q&A icon and a chat. Use the Q&A during the session if you have any specific questions about the products, and then use that chat if you're experiencing any kind of technical difficulties, if you can't hear me, if you can't see me. So whatever you want to talk about, just fire away with those and you'll be answered immediately. Today during this Duratex section, we have a panelist that's joining us, Wade Cervenka. And he will be answering those questions as we go, as well as interacting during the session. So let's get started. Wade, I actually wanted to let you introduce yourself and let everybody know how you've come to where you're at today with Duratex.
Of course. Thanks for having me on, Erin. Like Erin said, my name is Wade Cervenka. I am the national rep for Duratex and Brightline. So I've been with Grimco a little over 6 years now. And when we Grimco had acquired the wide format division of AGFA last summer, we were lucky enough to also bring with it the Duratex line of banner that I'm sure many of you have used or have heard of. And really, as I've gotten to travel the country this year before all the quarantines and everything, it's been a pleasure getting to meet with a lot of you and get to see all the Duratex banner. And I remember going back to even before we had acquired AGFA, running into the Duratex line in some of these shops, going in and seeing you container buyers who are buying just mountains and mountains of Duratex. And I was like, man, I really wish we could sell that line, because just a really well-respected, well-known name, quality and everything. So we're excited to teach you a little bit more about it today.
Absolutely. Yes. And like I said, I can't express enough. Keep firing away those questions. Keep Wade busy. He'll be answering them as quickly as he can. So let's get started. So So again, for all of you that have been buying your banner material from Grimco, you may, you know, a couple of years now, you notice that Grimco has gone through some transitions when it comes to scrim banner, when it comes to wide and grand format banner. Traditionally, we always carried the key and forward banner. I'm sure you guys have heard of that. But just like yourselves and just like in your shops, we had to get our banner supply or our banner offering consolidated. It just didn't make sense to carry, you know, two products that do the same thing, and then you've got two different versions, two different finishes, different lengths, and you've got a ton of different SKUs that are ultimately doing the same thing. So we decided to consolidate the line, and we offered temporarily the Brightline banner. Well, as that was getting consolidated and we were getting running with the Brightline banner offering, AGFA came to us and we had a great opportunity to acquire the Duratex line from AGFA. And you just don't pass up opportunities like that. So in 2019, we went through another transition and consolidated and decided to move everything over to the Duratex line. So when Grimco acquired Duratex, we didn't just acquire banner material. We acquired a team of experts. A grand format team reps, I'm sure if you have grand format equipment, you know your grand format team member in your area, but as well as a handful of employees overseas that are inside these factories manufacturing Duratex. They're inside these factories ensuring that the quality and it's made to our specifications, roll after roll, container after container. So we're not like a typical, you know, there's no middleman here. Grimco is working directly with the factories, and these products are made to our specifications to meet the needs of the majority of the market. But another thing I really want to drive home is when Grimco acquired the Duratex line, we did not change anything about the products. We did not change any manufacturing processes. We did not change any specifications. We simply just acquired the brand and now are honored to have that as a part of our exclusives. And we didn't change anything because this brand of banner material and fabrics, it comes with a lot of experience. This is not a new brand. This is not something that is on its first rodeo. This is a very well-respected and long-term brand that's been in the print houses for over 10 years. So again, this was a great opportunity for us to better service the wide and grand format market. Grimco is excited for the way it's been going. And I'm telling you, the sky's the limit. We're ready to jump in and we're ready to service you and all of our other customers with the Duratex line. So let's go ahead and get started. So Duratex, if you have seen any of our product books, our swatch books, which a new edition is coming out here soon, we're proofing it right now. You may know that Duratex is a very robust line. There are all kinds of flavors when it comes to Duratex. And what I mean by that is if you go online or go to Duratex, you don't get a really good visual of it, but go to DuratexMedia.com or go look at any of our Duratex products on Grimco.com and pull up the line card. You're going to see all these different flavors that are in this line. It is super, super robust. Another reason why we couldn't pass up the opportunity. So we've got the single-sided option. You've got your 13 ounce. And with that scrim, single-sided front lift scrim, with that comes our black back option as well. It's offered in 7, 8, and 13 ounce. We've got the double-sided or the blockout version, depending on how you like to refer to it. We've got mesh. We've got several different ratios of mesh. You've got your 8 ounce, your 9 ounce, your 12 ounce, and a speaker mesh. Remember those big events we used to go to when there would be covers over the huge speakers of these grand, you know, events at stadiums? That is a speaker mesh. It's, you know, very, very loosely wound, but we now have that available for all you grand format printers that are in the need of that. Backlit banner. So this is something that I encourage anybody that is doing illuminated signs with a backlit banner type of application. I know there's some other options out there that are very, very expensive. You've got to give us a call and let us tell you about these backlit options. Our 15 ounce and our 20 ounce. Nobody can touch our pricing and the quality is on point. So definitely give us a call if that's something that you are currently buying today. We'd like to talk to you about that. And then we've got the super smooth PET composite materials. So you've got the roll-up type applications. So composite film is basically just your composite. You've got the PET and PVC. So you've got a single-sided option and a double-sided option. More cost-effective than a true 100% traditional polyester film that you find a lot in those retractable stands. And then my personal favorite at the time is the 8 mil display film. That is something we'll show some examples of here in a minute, but it is a 8 mil polypropylene product that makes the double-sided window graphics a breeze. You don't need to, you know, reverse print on clear and flood with white and do all those other steps anymore. We've got your one step, two step, adding the mounting film application for you. So with that said, let's go ahead and talk about the most common product when it comes to banner, and that's 13 ounce front lit. So you might think, what in the world are we going to talk about? It's 13 ounce front lit, big deal. Well, I do want to specify that we talk to a lot of customers. So when we do things, like I mentioned earlier with Brightline, we ask our customers for feedback. We listen. That's the difference at Grimco. We actually think about, you know, what our customers are saying. What can we do to better service them and meet their needs? And the biggest thing that comes back time and time again with banner material, with 13 ounce banner material, is availability. So, you know, customers express to us, you know, obviously it's got to print great. I want the competitive price point, but I need to have it when I need it. I need this product to be delivered within 1 to 2 days. You've got to stock it. I'm telling you right now, I just got a confirmation that there are 20 containers on the water as we speak, with just thousands and thousands of rolls coming into a port in the next couple of days, next probably week or so. So our stock, 50 locations nationwide, they're already overflowing with banner, but we've got even more coming in because things are going to constantly pick up as the country starts to open up time and time again. So when it comes to the 13 ounce, the everyday 13 ounce that you guys all know, we have the two finishes, obviously, like every banner material. But what makes Duratex a little bit different is our gloss is a very high gloss. Some people really appreciate that high, wet look for gloss banner material, especially for your outdoor applications. But if you like a glossy, glossy banner, Duratex is going to be the one for you because it has that nice, glossy finish, primarily used outside because obviously it catches the glare of the interior lighting. The matte finish, it's a nice, in my opinion, more of like a satin. If you take a look at that, sometimes this finish is more of a happy medium. Maybe the gloss is too high. Maybe some of the other mattes are too dull and your prints just look bleh. Well, this matte finish on the Duratex product is going to be a nice happy medium. It has more of a satin touch to it, if you will. What we have, so on the other aspect of 13 ounce banner, we've got the 13 ounce matte printing right here on this Epson S60. We've been running this all day. We've been doing heavy, heavy saturations just to test the product. We're using the proper techniques. We're using the edge guards. We're using the right profile. If you've ever had difficulty of any banner buckling in your printer or when you bunching up, a lot of times a simple solution to that is just lowering your heat setting or increasing your vacuum. It's not necessarily the material. It's some settings that we can, you know, adjust to get that product printing well for you. Since we've been here today, this thing's been printing beautifully. So we keep changing it out. Duratex banner, I want to touch on something because as people talk about 13 ounce banner, everybody assumes everybody's selling 1,000 by 1,000 scrim. But I'm telling you, we've come across some bids and some quotes in the past where we're not truly comparing apples to apples. So we have some things about our banner that is a little unique in the fact that we do test other products. We do test them to make sure that they are truly what they're claiming to be. So our product is a true 1,000 by 1,000 denier. We've come across a lot of alternative products that are an 840 by 840 that technically sometimes claim to be 1,000 by 1,000. But what does that really mean? What is denier? So last night when we were going over some things, I was telling everybody that I was going to rip some banner on camera, and it was very awkward because I couldn't rip it. So we did some pre-ripping with some guys in the back, and I wanted to show really close, some close-up visuals of what I mean by denier. Denier is just the unit of measure that determines the thickness of the thread. So the higher the denier, the stronger the product. I think you can see there pretty clear that thread that is in between here. So if you're picturing the way the banner is manufactured, you've got this netting and this weaving of scrim. So our scrim is extremely strong, being that 1,000 by 1,000 denier. It's going to be able to withstand the outdoor elements, the high winds, the cold to the hot, anything you want to put it through. It, when you've got a 500 by 500 or an 840 by 840, it's going to be more likely to rip, especially in those grommeted areas. So whenever it comes to finishing the banner, it can be, you know, traditionally finished with double-sided banner tape, You can sew it, web it, whatever you want to do, weld it. Everybody's doing everything. Again, it's offered from 38 inch all the way up to 196. So if you, you know, want to do a true comparison, make sure you're looking at the spec sheets and the fine print to make sure you're comparing it to apples to apples. So another topic we've got to discuss today is the white point. When it comes to white point, I know this is very important for a lot of people, but something to remind yourself of is when you're comparing white point, there's good things you can do and bad things you can do. My biggest suggestion is take the banner outside. When you're comparing a white point right next to another product inside, you've got all these fluorescent lights and different kind of lighting inside. If you take it outside where it's eventually going to be installed anyway, you'll see that the Duratex white point is very, very natural. It's a very clean white product. Some white points, again, white is, there's 50 shades of white. It's in the eyes of the beauty of the eyes of the beholder. So if you're looking at it, some people see a blue tint, some people might see it as a yellow tint, different brands that vary from factory to factory. But what was the most important to us is to have an excellent white point that was consistent from roll to roll to roll. So container after container, you're going to get that same consistent true white point. But again, a lot of times we get perceived differently when we're looking under the fluorescent lighting. So what customers have always told me, what I, again, like Michael Kerber's been explaining all day, we learn so much from you. And somebody very wise told me, if you're ever going to judge a white point of the banner, you got to take it outside to get the true effect of it. So let's see, on the, going back to the different specifications that you guys have expressed to us that are important to you, Duratex has always been a print side in product. It's always been what is also considered as reverse wound. Formerly we had the forward banner that was a print side out, but Duratex, again, we didn't want to change anything about the formula once we adopted this brand. We didn't want to change the recipe that's been working so well. So why is it print side in? Well, print side in actually protects it from getting all the oil and grease and residue from your hands when you're changing the banner in and out of your machine. So we had a lot of people request, bring back the print side out, bring back the print side out. So we did. So now we have inventory of the 38, 54, and 63 inch by the 115 foot rolls. So they're the shorter rolls. Traditionally they're 164. So we now do offer those in the print side out version for people that prefer to load it that way. One is not technically better than the other. They both work, but it's user preference. So if that's what you like, now you can order that. It's on grimco.com. Call your rep. We've got it available for you. So circling to the bottom line of scrim banner, a lot of people say it's banner. It's the cheapest thing we can offer the end user. It's, you know, people get so worked up over all nitpicking all the little things. But the point of 13-ounce banner is it's got to print well, it's got to be available, and it's got to be at an aggressive price point. And we can nail all three of those with Duratex. So again, if you're not printing on Duratex today, I encourage you to give it a shot, buy a roll, bring it into your shop, do your testing, do your printing, and you'll see for yourself that this price point, this quality, and this availability is going to find a good spot into your shop. So Wade, is there anything else you want to add on 13-ounce banner? I know that you have had several customers do some trials.
Yeah, so great point. I'm almost every week I get approached, whether it's from customers or from some of our reps, and they say, hey, I've got a customer, they have a large bid out, you know, 100, 200 rolls, you name it, but they wanna try it out. And we at Grimco and with Duratex and a lot of our products, we always offer that, you know, 100% satisfaction guarantee. And until you get to printing on it and get it in your own shop, like, yes, we have printed samples, we can do that so you can get an idea of how it's going to look. But obviously, you want to get it in your hands. You want to get it in your shop. I encourage you, for those shops who have, taken a chance in the past, ordered 3-5 rolls just to say, hey, let's get this printing, see how it works. I would say 95% of the time, if not every time, they come back, they place that order, they're happy with the quality. And like Erin said, we have so much control over the product that whether you have a program that's going to run for a couple of weeks, a couple of months, you name it, that first roll you print on, that quality will be there throughout. And so you're going to have that same result every time, which is ultimately what you and your end clients are looking for.
Exactly. And I kind of get excited when people say, you know what, I'm going to buy a roll. I'm going to see if I like it. I'll let you know. That's kind of a thrill, kind of a rush, because they're always going to call us back and order more. So let's move on to the blockout versions. Again, we're going to really dive into the 13-ounce scrim and the blockouts, because those are two of the most popular flavors when it comes to banner in the Duratex line into the everyday print shop. So blockout banner, what is it used for? Obviously double-sided prints. Whenever you need to do a double-sided print, you can't, it's not coated both sides on the scrim, so you've got to move up to a blockout that can be ink receptive on both sides. So the construction of blockout banner, if you don't know already, you've got your black polyester core in the middle, and then it's laminated both sides with PVC. We talked about the denier earlier. Blockout banner, typically when you get 16 ounce and below, you're going to be dealing with a lighter denier because it's got to have that really smooth finish. This is our 15 ounce, and I'm telling you, it's so soft and smooth. If you don't have a print sample, we'll get some to you per your request. But this material is so incredibly soft. If it was, we could make sheets out of it. I would sleep on it, I swear. It. We've got several different weights as well. We've got 12, 13, 15, 16, and two versions of 18. Is that overwhelming? It can be, but you can break it down very easily. So when you're thinking blockout banner material, it's going to come down to two basic things. Price and application. So if you're going to be using a blockout banner, I would always recommend think 15 ounce and below interior. That is to give you that really clean, can't really see it from back here, but when you are shopping or when you're at a Starbucks or when you're at, you know, any kind of space where you're up close to a banner and the customer is advertising, you don't want to see that scrim. You don't want to see that scrim that you're going to see on a curbside pickup banner. You want to see a nice, clean, crisp look. So again, 15 ounce and below is what we're going to recommend for interior applications. And then which one do I choose? You said you got 12, 13, 15. Well, maybe the price point's going to be what it comes down to. And keep in mind, once you take a look through the DuratexMedia.com or the offering, majority of some of these products, like the 12 ounce, I believe, they may only be offered in grand format. So before you start pitching it to your customers, make sure that you're talking about a product that fits your printer. A lot of them, most of them do all come in the narrow format, but there are some black backs and so forth that obviously are just in your grand format sizes. So we've got the 16 ounce blockout. That is going to be an economical version to use outdoors. So if you are very price driven with a price driven for an application, that one is only offered in the 10 foot widths, but that would be the go-to. And I want to discuss the two differences between the 18 ounce. Like I mentioned, we've got 18 ounce standard, 18 ounce premium. Don't overthink it. 18 ounce standard, you're looking at about a 1 year outdoor durability. And it's got a, there's no fire rating on it. So it is not an FR product. And it's only got a 9x9 weave versus the 18 ounce standard or 18 ounce premium, which is going to be the go-to for your long-term pole banners with the pockets and all that good stuff. That is fire retardant. It is a 3 to 5 year outdoor durability. You will get more time out of that as long as conditions are normal. And then it's got 20x20 weave. So it's super, super smooth. I've got a customer up in New York that's actually using it as rooftops for a tent structure, and they're wrapping scaffolding with it because it's durable. It's being used confidently that it's going to be able to withstand the elements outdoors, and it's going to handle all of that welding that they did very nicely. So what I have here is the, this is just something we printed on the 12 ounce blockout. I wanted to just show, again, we don't skip any steps when it comes to construction. When it comes to our specifications, and like I mentioned, all of our employees that are in the factories and making sure that no steps are being skipped to save any money. This is our lightest blockout version. And I've got there is a dimly lit channel letter behind here that I was going to try to show off, but I wasn't really impressed by how light it was. So we've got, So I use this little light here just to show how extremely opaque this is. Again, this is our lightest version. So the difference between 12 ounce, 13, 15 is the amount of PVC that's laminated on it. So So I just want to, again, if there was a print on this other side, there is going to be no bleed through. There is a solid black polyester core in there. Put that right there. So the smooth feature of that, again, it's a very nice, clean product. I encourage everybody to start implementing that into their offerings with the banner, the Duratex Blockout. Also, when it comes to smooth film, since we're talking about the smooth products by Duratex, something we can't go without mentioning, like I said earlier, is that 8 mil polypropylene. This is flying off of the shelf. I encourage everybody to learn and stick with me on this one. So 8 mil display film, very scratch, tear resistant. It's a beautiful smooth. I just love the smooth products, the nice scrimless type material. And again, it won't scratch, won't rip. And what this is used primarily for in construction in combination with a mounting film. So like I said, these double-sided window graphics that we see more and more of, and a lot of people call us in like, customer wants a double-sided window graphic. What's the best way to do that? Do I need to reverse print on clear and then flood it with white and then put a block out with another print? You know, that was very hard to go over with a lot of customers. So think of this next time you get that type of application. Double-sided printable, latex and UV only, and it's mounted with the bright line permanent removable mounting film. This mounting film actually comes with a air release channels on the removable side. The liner is labeled to remove for adhesive. So as you can see, we've got now one side that you would just, it's also referred to as push-pull application. You can just push it on there and then you've achieved your double-sided window film. So kind of zooming in here, nice, clean, welcome to Vegas. Vegas, come back and see us soon. Very cost effective and, you know, again, a great solution for any time you're needing to do double-sided printing. Good scratch resistancy. No need to laminate unless you're going to put that mounting film on top of it. Wade, have you had a lot of good experience with the mounting film in the past?
Yeah, this product is one that I've really enjoyed, you know, before the whole lockdown occurred going into some of these shops. It's an eye catcher. It's something that we haven't offered a solution like this in the past. And I know a lot of sign companies out there like yours are looking for new, creative, less cumbersome ways to produce these opaque double-sided window graphics. Like you said, in the past, you'd have to do a four-step process or do a five-layer print on a clear where you need a white ink layer. This is just one of those items that customers cannot get enough of because, like I said, it's simple, easy to use, the print looks great, and it's going to save you a lot of time and effort and be a lot more cost-effective.
Perfect. Yeah, exactly. And I'm telling you guys, this, I can't reiterate it enough. You know, Duratex banner, this line, this brand, it's not new. This is something that we have the opportunity to acquire and add to our exclusives. And customers are used to this, especially in that grand format space. This product has proven itself over and over. You'd be amazed at the amount of rolls that are actually being sold every day from 38 inch to 16 foot. We've got thousands of rolls being delivered to customers with consistent quality from roll to roll. And then we've also got the profiles on grimco.com. If you want to go there and check out, use our profiles that we've created. But yeah, we're ready to service you guys when it comes to all your banner needs, anything from mesh to blockout, to double-sided print films, to scrim, blackback, you name it. So we can go now over to Wade. Do we have any questions that have come across during the presentation?
Yeah, we've got a couple, especially on that last one that you were referring to, that double-sided window film. One of the questions that was asked was, does it require white ink, which you touched on, but if you want to hit on that again, like, I don't know if in the sample you can show that it has a white point on both sides, maybe in one of the sections.
That is a great point. I also wanted to mention on the Duratex scrim banner, all the blockout banners, any kind of Duratex PVC product that we're offering you has an excellent white point. So all of your unprinted areas are still going to pop. It does, I don't know how to explain a white point over the video unless I hold it up to something. But what I'm saying is all of the unprinted area on all of your banners or on this product are still going to be bright white and very crisp, very clean. And it also contributes to the colors really popping. It's got a beautiful canvas to lay down on, a beautiful base color so that your reds and your yellows and your greens really do pop. Okay.
Yeah, it's not always the easiest thing to show on video, but you're doing great. Don't worry. Another question that came through earlier is since you were mentioning some of our employees that we had acquired who work kind of overseas and with some of these factories, and I have a little anecdotal story I can share on this. But as far as you know, how can you control some of the quality and things that go into this, you know, with some of these employees, and one of the stories that I've heard. From our employees over there is when it comes to quality control, there are, as you know, in your shop, if there are corners to be cut to save time, to save money, you can make that decision if you choose, if you're in a rush and last minute and you know, have to cut a corner in order to get a job out the door. Sometimes you have to do it. But for us, quality is everything. When we put our name behind any of these Grimco branded products, whether it's Brightline, Hanley LED, Duratex, Ion PVC, you name it, we're not going to cut any of those corners. And a great example I heard was with the 15-ounce product or any of our double-sided blockout products, a coating in the manufacturing process gets applied to both sides. There are factories overseas that will apply this coating to both the top and the bottom of the banner at the same exact time. Well, as that goes through the line, obviously the layer of coating that's going to go on the top of that banner is going to be different and affected differently by gravity than what's getting coated onto the bottom side. So where a lot of factories will coat top and bottom at the same time, we've instructed all of our factories that produce our double-sided banner products to not only just run the banner through the coater on the top side, flip that banner over, and then coat it again. That way you're going to get an even coating on both sides. That's some of the quality and the little details that we put in to these products to make sure they meet your specifications and that you're going to continue to get nice prints over and over again.
And great point. And I've been, like I said in the beginning, I've been managing Brightline and Duratex for a couple of years now. And I will tell you that there's no brand out there or there's no product segment out there that is a, you know, 100% guaranteed free of any type of defect ever. It's the nature of our business. It's the nature of our products, the nature of the way things are manufactured that we print on. But I will tell you this, you'll notice on every single roll of Duratex banner that you buy, there is a lot number. There's a lot of encrypted codes in that lot number. It's not just a random spit out series of numbers. And I've actually traced the lot number back to the team overseas. And we've been able to pull some retains that they keep for up to 18 months. So if we ever have a question about a specific lot number, hey, could you just measure the thickness on this? Customer was concerned, thought it felt a little bit thinner than the previous roll or what have you. But rest assured that those lot numbers aren't just there to make you feel good. There is a whole chain that can go back to that factory, to the manufacture date. They pull samples from that day and we have all the technology and all the equipment to test it. We are in daily communication. That team is led by a man named Arthur, and I speak with him every day. And he not only, you know, holds them accountable for a standard of quality and hitting our specifications, but they also hold all of these people accountable for shipping out timely, for making sure that our POs are shipping out timely so that it constantly flows. We've got inventory on the shelf, in the water, and on order. So again, our responsibility is to make sure that we've got the product available to you when you need it.
Another question, Erin. People are always looking for profiles for their machines. Do you want to just do a quick chat on where our customers can find profiles?
Yeah, we have a section on grimco.com under our software support. From there, it will lead you to our profiles. So we have many, many profiles listed on grimco.com for, especially for the roll-to-roll latex machines and the Epsons, like the one running behind me. We've got the blockout profiles, the 13-ounce profiles. Now, I will say we don't, being that we're not a distributor for Roland, Mamaki, Muto, we don't have those machines in-house to write our custom profiles or to do profiling for them, but we can always recommend settings if you want. We've got a technician team that can always help out if you're really lost and struggling with some certain settings to print successfully on our product. So yeah, you can definitely find a ton of Brightline profiles and then a ton of Duratex profiles on Grimco.com. What else you got, Wade?
Let's see, what else do we have here? Do you want to touch on a couple of our mesh offerings? We got a few folks asking a little bit about some of the mesh products we have.
Yeah, we've got a, again, we've always traditionally carried the 8-ounce mesh in the forward banner and blockout, or I'm sorry, in the key banner. So Duratex, we've got the 8, 9, and 12, and then that 6-ounce mesh that I mentioned, not very common, but it's cool to know where to come and get it if you ever need it. So what this is here is our 8-ounce mesh with liner. Majority of all of our wide format customers gravitate towards this product. It does have a 70-30 airflow to it, but a nice synthetic liner here that once removed after printing, you'll notice that it's got a really nice mesh weave to it. You can kind of see behind here, but it gives still that color a really nice pop, and it gives, again, going back to that white point, it looks super sharp when it's installed. But again, the greens, the blues, everything, the reds, but this is our 8-ounce mesh. If you want a tighter weave, you would step up to our 9-ounce mesh option, which I don't know if I have a sample here. But the 9-ounce premium mesh, that does not come with a liner. So if you don't have a liner kit or the ability to print on a mesh product without liner, that wouldn't be something I would suggest for you. But that one has a tighter mesh, so the color might be a little bit more vibrant for you. And then the 12-ounce supreme mesh, this one is really, really cool because it's a double-sided mesh product. The 12-ounce mesh, now that does only come in the grand format space, but you know, if we see enough demand of it, these are things that we can listen to you. If this is something that our wide format printers are requesting, a double-sided mesh, we can, you know, possibly bring that in a wide format size. Then yeah, the speaker mesh, and then the 8-ounce mesh with the black back. A lot of that is used for construction sites and so forth.
Mm. Perfect. One thing too, I wanted to mention, I got word from Neil that who, after he finished printing those banners, that if you were interested at all in one of those Duratex banners that you saw being run on the Epson today, feel free to just shoot us a little line in the Q&A section. We'd be happy to send any of those out to you. But did you get a chance to touch on backlit banner at all, Erin? I know we've had a few requests on a couple of our backlit products.
Yeah. So the backlit products, again, those are offered in a 15 or 20 ounce version. Obviously, there's the price comparison on those as well with the weight, but these products are ideally used for a lot of your illuminated cabinets, something similar to like a Panagraphics type product, but the price point is going to be much, much more competitive, but beautiful coating on these, ink receptive for all ink platforms. But this is also something that, you know, if you're doing a lot of illuminated backlits, Panagraphics, this is something to definitely think about adding to your lineup as well. But yeah, Wade, I know that a lot of customers are welding it successfully. Very, very happy with the print quality that they're getting, the color pop, the true reds. It's really, really a phenomenal product.
Totally. So one of the questions that's come up a bit, and I'll be happy to answer that on the double-sided window film that you showed. So just to try to explain it, and I always have to slow down and try to explain this as best I can in front of a customer. So the film Erin displayed, it is a double-sided polypro film, and it is white on both sides with no adhesive. So you would print side one, and then if you have a printer like the HP Latex machine that can read an OMOS line, basically it's a registration line, once you flip the media over and go to rerun it back through the printer, that's how you get your even registration, so you can line it up nicely on both sides. Once you've printed it, then how you would apply it to a window is you would then laminate a mounting film to one of the sides. We have a couple of different mounting films in the Brightline family. The most popular one and the one that comes on some of our printed samples and that Erin had used in her little demo there is, it is a clear mounting adhesive that is permanent on one side. The permanent side is what you laminate to the display film. The other side then will have a removable liner. And on that adhesive, it is a removable, so perfect for windows. It'll come off nice and clean without leaving behind a residue, as well as it has a air egress liner on it. So anybody from a gas station clerk to the most novice of installers can put it on the window. Bubble free, makes it really nice and easy. It's nice and thick, so it's contour cuttable as well. We cut a lot of our samples on our Esco flatbed router, but conceivably you could run it through a plotter as well after you had laminated the adhesive to it. So I hope that clarifies it for some of you there.
Yeah, the double-sided display film, this product right here, it's offered in a 38 and 54 inch. If you guys want more information, pricing, and all that good stuff, just reach out to us and let us know. But I can guarantee once you print on this film, once you bring it in-house and start giving your customers this double-sided window graphic solution paired with a Brightline mounting film, you'll get repeat business over and over because, you know, what's the point of printing or advertising only on one side of the window when you've got people coming in and you've got people going out? So I know that a lot of times our customers are printing for, you know, the local pizza shop or the local florist, and we've always traditionally sent them maybe static cling. But as you've gone back after they've applied it themselves, it's kind of painful to see all the bubbles and everything that those static cling applications by end users end up looking like. So this would give them that air release, that rigidity, the double-sided, they can't really mess it up. So that's the beauty of this. I love products in Duratex and in Brightline that you guys can print and ship to customers, and they can do their own installation and be very, very impressed with themselves and with you as a supplier. So again, this is the polypropylene film. This is a product that we were inherited along with Duratex. So the price point here being that we are, you know, sourcing this direct, it's a beautiful product at a very aggressive price point. So I encourage you guys to seek out more information on the Duratex 8mm polypropylene. So I think that, where are we at? I think right now we're going to go ahead, unless you got more questions, anything else coming through there, Wade?
No, that's pretty much it.
Friday afternoon.
Yeah, everybody's either cracked open their cold ones or headed home to, hopefully have an enjoyable Mother's Day weekend.
Awesome. Well, yeah, good point. I forgot about that. So thank you guys so much. This has been such an awesome day. We enjoy this. Again, we're here because you're here, and this is only the beginning. As everybody is kind of getting used to this new way of doing things, we're excited about it. I will tell you one thing, Grimco does not get caught on our heels. We love to adapt. We love to come to you with new ideas, innovative ideas to get you guys where you need to be as far as offering more versatile films, cost-effective films, and getting you comfortable with new applications that are going to be coming up over and over, whether it be, you know, the floor graphics to display films. We've got you covered. We're constantly looking for ways to find products that help you expand your business at aggressive price points. And this is what we love to do. We love to help you grow because without you, we wouldn't be here. So have a great weekend. Happy Mother's Day. And stay tuned for the next Grimco Virtual Trade Show.